Namaskar. Today in Northeast Diary, we have with us Mrs. Dilkumari Bhandari, who was a member of parliament and has consistently been a driving force for the Nepali language in India. Dear listeners, Nepali language was included in the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution on 20th August 1992. The struggle for formal recognition of Nepali language started from Dehradun in 1956 and it was translated into reality 36 years later. On 20th August 1992, Mrs. Dilkumari Bhandari, the then Member of Parliament in Lok Sabha from Sikkim, presented the bill on the floor of the house. Her contribution towards the recognition of Nepali as an official language in India has been immense. Recently, Premier Literary Association of Sikkim, Nepali Sahitya Parishad, has announced her name for this year's Bhanu Puraskar, which is awarded for excellence in or contribution to language and literature in Sikkim. The award is named after the foremost poet in Nepali language, Adikavi Bhanubhakta Acharya. Today we will have a conversation with Mrs. Dilkumari Bhandari. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, and my greetings to your listeners of All India Radio.
What brought you to the core of Nepali language's struggle for inclusion as an official language?
To reply this question, I would start with, I'm a very, very patriotic person.
Yes.
And I always say, I am an Indian. I speak Nepali language. And now, at present, I can say that my language is in the 8th schedule of our constitution. But as you said, the language, to get the language there, we had to have a lot of hard work. And when I look back, when I go down the memory lane, when we fought for our language, it wasn't easy. It was a difficult time. Sometimes it used to become arduous. And I came to that because of my love for my
language.
And God was kind, more than God, forgive me to say that, God, that the people of India, the spirit of democracy, that prevailed. And otherwise, a lone MP from Sikkim couldn't have done that. So they helped, belonging to all parties. And like two, three other MPs were Nepali-speaking people, but most of them were not Nepali-speaking people. But they respected our feelings and how we were, like injustice was meted out to us, not including our language in its schedule. Despite eminent member of Raj Bhasha Ayog, Dr. Suninti Kumar Chatterjee, he had to give dissent note to the report of the Raj Bhasha Ayog, saying that the wishes of the people and the importance of the language should have been considered and Nepali and Sindhi should have been included. That was his comment in the dissent note. So that also encouraged us, not only encouraged, because we knew injustice was done to us because then I was quite a young child. But looking back, when we were struggling for the recognition of the language, since 1926, the Britishers had recognized our language. How come when we got our own independence and our own country, our constitution didn't include our language? So we were into the fray. We fought, but happily the end was good and positive. So today, with pride and happiness, we say our language is recognized by constitution and it's in the 8th schedule of our constitution.
Could you please tell us about the history of the struggle for the recognition of Nepali as an official language?
Struggle, if I go into the history, it will be very long. But like, since in your question only, you said Anand Singh Thapa from Dehradun He was the editor of Jagrat Gorkha then, and his co-editors, they jointly signed a letter sent to Dr. Rajendra Prasad, our first president. It started with that. And people were becoming educated, and they came to know what had happened, and they also started for joining that race, I can say. Then, like all over India, in the first stage, might be not. Around that time, it was Darjeeling and Kalimpong. They were leading the movement. So, Nepali Bhasha Adhyayan Samiti was formed in Kalimpong, and Motichand Pradhan, president of that organization, sent letter to Indira Gandhi, the then Prime Minister. Perhaps that was the first letter to the Prime Minister for the demand for inclusion of Nepali language in the 8th schedule. After that, so many organizations came into existence and they started strengthening the movement. And in Darjeeling, Nepali Bhasha Samiti was formed. And in Northeast, Dehradun, Himachal, everywhere organizations came out. But when Nepali Bhasha Samiti was leading the show, it renamed itself Akhil Bharatiya Nepali Bhasha Samiti, and other fringe organizations who were working for the recognition of Bhasha recognition, they also came and joined this organization. So it was a huge organization which had almost 500 shakhas, branches in all over the country. So they were driving force around that time to us, request or demand, whatever you can say, the inclusion of Nepali language.
Could you please share your experience at the time of the Constitution Amendment Bill introduction in the Parliament for Nepali?
Nepali language, people came to know that this was not given it place in its schedule. So people who knew that this is also a rich language and all, in 1971 only, Dr. Karan Singh from Jammu Kashmir, he had introduced a private member bill. After that, Satyen Mazumdar, I think he had put bill or question, I'm not very sure. Then K.B. Chhetri from Kharsang and many other, like mine was 19th private member bill. Okay. So before me, 18 people had, MPs had already given their bill and it was discussed. But in the lack of support in the house, it was fallen. They were fallen, I mean. So they couldn't give us fruit, but they supported. So when I put my, pressed my bill in the house, that was the 19th one. And during the discussion, 3 days discussion, according to the rule, when the introductor of the bill speaks and the other speakers also have spoken, the minister of the concerned department give the reply. So State Home Minister M.M. Jacob, he spoke and he requested me to withdraw the bill since they understood the mood of the house and they were ready to bring government bill on that. So I withdrew the bill. After that, he had promised to bring the bill during the monsoon session of the parliament. We were waiting and discussing, but there was no bill. I was also waiting with bated breath, kab aayega, but it didn't. So I requested all the senior leaders to press for the bill to be brought in the monsoon session only. So on the 19th, before the question hour, all the senior leaders, they charged the government and they put them on the dock saying, you have promised on the floor of the house that you will bring the bill for the Nepali language in this monsoon session. Where is the bill? So there was uproar. So many things happened. Then speaker, honorable speaker also took them to task saying, since you have given your words on the floor of the house, where is the bill? Then honorable minister, S.P. Chauhan stood up and said, we'll bring it tomorrow if the house agrees. Because there are so many rules to bring a bill in the house, even if it is a government bill. So, honorable speaker, he asked the members, if you are ready to forego the rules, he is ready to bring the bill tomorrow. So everybody says, yes, we'll forego the bill. Because everybody has decided that we support this bill. We have spoken at length, so we will support. Then he said, then what about the rules? So they say, let it be like that, let it go. Then when house was assured by all the members from all sides, it was decided that tomorrow the bill will come. That was on the 20th August of 1992. Then next day, first hour of the parliament, setting aside the question hour, the bill was taken up and everybody said, ki, we have discussed so much on Mrs. Bhandari's bill. So what is the use of again saying same things again and again? So we can forego the discussion and let us pass the bill. So speaker asked everybody whether they agree. So everybody said 100% say yes, we agree. Then house was put to vote and 346 out of 346 voted for the bill and the bill was declared passed. And after some time, it was as a rule sent to Rajya Sabha, and in Rajya Sabha also the people present, MPs present, 110, they also voted 100%, 110 upon 110. So it was also with all the support of all the MPs, Rajya Sabha also passed the bill. So from that day on, we were very happy, we rejoiced. And after that, 31st of August. President, Mahamahim President also put his seal, and our language is in the 8th schedule of our constitution.
This is very inspiring. After years of struggle, Nepali language was incorporated in the 8th schedule. Are you satisfied with the progress that has been made since then?
We were happy when it was considered fit to be in the 8th schedule. And before that, even Saith Academy, which sets parameters of the quality of literary work people have, languages have, and give their awards. So Nepali was considered for that. My only complaint would be, I see so many books coming to the market, so many aspiring literary people, they are writing so many, mostly poems I come across, and small books.
Yes.
But somehow I feel our literature lack in child education materials.
Bal Sahitya.
I think recently, 1 or 2 years back, Mrs. Snehlata Rai was awarded Sahitya Academy Award. Apart from that, I don't see many people writing.
Dr. Shanti Chhetri.
Dr. Shanti Chhetri. And she also writes mostly creative writing she has. Bal Sahitya, very few, I think.
She also received Bal Sahitya Puraskar.
And Bal Sahitya Puraskar.
Mr. Shankar Dhakal and Bhim Pradhan. They were awarded.
But somehow, I am most of the time out of the state and maybe I have missed them. But I have not come across this Bal Sahitya, which are up to the mark. Forgive me saying this, but I see other languages of the country. So to come at par with those languages, we have to make effort. We have to make effort.
Okay.
So now there are so many facilities. Government give resources we get. So we can, if our writers make effort, they are very good writers and they are talented. They can write.
How has the community benefited from this recognition, in the 8th schedule of the constitution?
Very good question. I was waiting for that. when we were demanding the 8th schedule for our language, we used to, educated people were mostly, I suppose, they knew why. But our people all over, we used to unite them and tell them, ki, why you are asking for this? So if you if we get this language, your children will get services. There will be so many facilities. In fact, we had printed a booklet of all the facilities we are going to get after the recognition of the language. But after the recognition of the language, somehow people forgot also about that book. And they now ho gaya, we got it, now it's okay. Everybody went on their ways. But the motto, the motivation, why we went there, why we asked that, it's yes, the love of language and all the languages are in the air schedule, why not ours? Yes. That feeling was there. But the most prominent wishes of the people was to get opportunities to improve their lifestyle. Lives. But somehow people didn't make effort. It's still open. People can join. And after the recognition of the language, I bought so many UPSC syllabus and distributed to educate our youths so that they will get motivated and sit for interviews and get at par with other people speaking other languages. But somehow that didn't happen because it's not easy. There are facilities. You have to go and get it. You have to search for it. Nobody is going to come and dole it out to you. So that effort we have to make. That's not being made.
Okay. Moving on. How do you feel about being awarded the Bhanu Puraskar in Sikkim this year?
Yes, I feel happy. Like a premier organization like Nepali Sahitya Parishad Sikkim, they have been doing so much for the development of the language. And when they decided, might be, they have considered so many things. So I accepted and lot of thanks to them. And Bhanu Puraskar, as you said, like Bhanu, our Adikavi.
Adikavi.
And Nepali speaking people were inspired to read and write Nepali because of him only. When he translated
Ramayana
from Sanskrit to Nepali, it was in Lok Bhasa. So everybody could read that, relate to that, and speak that. So people had that feeling that they should read and write, if not try to read, so that they could read Bhanu Bhakta Ramayana. And when I spoke in Lok Sabha for this language, I had said that Bhanu Bhakta had written somewhere, Bado Durlab Janus Bharat Bhumiko Janma Janane. Then when our demand was fulfilled, I really felt that he was right in his expression.
You have also contributed in the field of journalism as the editor of Aajako Sikkim weekly and daily newspaper published from Sikkim. Please share your experience in this regard.
Taking over as editor of Aajako Sikkim from Mr. Bhandari was not easy because I was not a writer. For me, only managing the weekly, after that it became daily also, from weekly to bi-weekly, then
daily.
Then after me, our youths, Nepali-speaking youths, they were, a lot of people used to get employment from my praise. Then they very nicely ran the ongoing works of the praise and the paper. But side by side, I was looking after Aajako Sikkim publication. Then today when you ask, I can proudly say that I was instrumental in publishing so many Nepali books. And on top of that, I'm proud saying that one single publication got 3 Academy Awards, like Tulsi Ram Kashyap's Ama.
Yeah.
Then Ramlal Adhikari's Nishan Smaran and MP Rai's Beer Jati Ko Amar Kahani. So I'm proud to say that my publication got 3 Academy Awards. So that's my experience.
What further measures should be taken to give an impetus to the increased use of Nepali language on the national and global fora?
I'm not that literary visionary, but I feel like to give impetus to the development of our language. And when you say global, I sort of, we haven't made it even the national. Yes, there are now organizations on the international level. They are organizing seminars and all.
Yes.
But I take pride in saying that at present, we have person as our prime minister who is very much connected to the roots of the country, and he has vision, and he very effectively motivated people, and I am very, very thankful to him for making Niti Aayog to go for investigate and make Nayi Shiksha Niti 2020. Now it's going to be in force, and what I like about that is it has given lot of impetus, importance to languages of people.
People. Matribhasa.
Matribhasa. So if our people really want to progress and go forward, this is one opportunity when the government is giving this impetus and has become a driving force for this. So I'm hopeful, very hopeful, that if our people are ready for this and sincerely they go about it, we certainly will go forward.
Moving on to the final question, what would you suggest the youth for the development and protection of Nepali language?
As I said earlier, our youth, they are very versatile. And youth population in our country, not only in the country, in our Nepali-speaking population also, they are in great number. And most importantly, youths have very open mind. And with education, they know who they are.
Okay.
But it's only the people at the helm of affairs, they have to give them right direction. So if we are able to do that, our youths will do wonders. I am very, very I believe in that if we give them right direction, they are able to do that. I come across brilliant poems written in Nepali. People complain that youth of today, they don't respect language, they don't respect our literature, culture and all. Yes, there are effects of other cultures, and the onslaught of the digital world, they are affected too. But when you give them proper, strong roots, they will come up. So, but my request to the youth would be, they should also come forward, as with the education, horizon of their visions have expanded. So they should take advantage of this. And it's not like when we were youth, we didn't have all these opportunities, all these facilities. They are lucky. They have born at this age where even the country is leaping forward. But for the corona, it is a little bit in the quandrum, but it's moving forward. So our youth also can do wonders if they endeavor. So it's not an easy work to go forward. They have to make effort. They have to respect their language, education, their own youth also. Their youth now, the youth power, their own power of their body itself and mind can be used in right direction. They can achieve so many things. So they have to make effort.
Today, Mrs. Dilkumari Bhandari blessed us with her presence and gave us an insight into her struggle for the recognition of Nepali language in the 8th schedule of the Constitution and shared her experience of being awarded the Bhanu Puraskar 2021. We thank you for your contribution towards this cause, including the development of Nepali language and literature. Ma'am, thank you for being with
us. Thank you so much. Thank you.